A total solar eclipse is one of the universe's most spectacular natural events. Or so I've heard. I haven't actually seen one yet, so don't take it from me. Here's how folks described the last total solar eclipse to pass through Maine in 1963.
It was getting spooky dark, which was a little strange.
You see this incredible shadow rushing toward you.
And the air temperature dropped so much and so quickly.
Couldn't have been more dramatic to go from the bright sunshine in the afternoon to, you know, what felt like the middle of the night.
The whole moon was in front, and then we could see the whole rim around the outside kind of glowing.
Solar flares coming out from the sun. It just looked like big fires.
You could tell these animals were confused. The birds were flying all over the place. You know, it was kind of an eerie feeling. You knew you were experiencing something that was quite rare.
Now, more than 60 years later, the celestial event will traverse the Pine Tree State again. And by all accounts, it's an event you won't want to miss. So what is a total solar eclipse? And does it really live up to all the hype? That's what we're diving into today. I'm Esta Pratt-Kielley. This is Maine Explained. A total solar eclipse happens when the moon completely covers the sun, casting a shadow on the Earth.
To experience a total solar eclipse is for a brief dark moment to live within the shadow of the moon. Wow.
A total solar eclipse is an incredibly unique and rare event to witness. The moon orbits the Earth about every 28 and a half days, but we don't get an eclipse every month.
The moon is at a 5-degree inclination with respect to the plane of our planet towards the sun. So because of that 5-degree inclination, we are not getting that alignment of the moon, Earth, and the sun every month.
So a total solar eclipse only happens about every 18 months or so. And because the Earth is rotating, it doesn't traverse the same path too often. Plus, more than 70% of the Earth's surface is ocean.
So most of the time when solar eclipses are happening, they just go over the ocean and they never cross the land.
So in any given place on Earth, you're only likely to see a total solar eclipse about once a century.
It affects the light, it affects the way the air feels, it affects the animals. It's just a multi-sensory event, and you're sort of like plunged into it. Goes from partial eclipse, partial eclipse, partial eclipse, boom, suddenly you're like in this different world.
Greenfield Boyce says it's the celestial event to see. And fortunately, a large swath of Maine will have that chance on April 8th, 2024. The path of totality stretches from the southwest of the United States to the northeast, starting in Texas and finishing its American journey in Houlton, Maine. That may seem counterintuitive when Maine sees the sunrise first each day. But a total solar eclipse always travels from west to east. That's because the Earth and the Moon rotate counterclockwise. Jackman and Houlton are both at the center of totality. Viewers there will see the eclipse for the longest amount of time, about 3.5 minutes. So get as close to the center of totality as possible. Every second counts. And make sure you're actually in the path of totality, not even 5 miles outside of it, or you won't see the total solar eclipse.
The difference between seeing a partial and a total is the difference between seeing a lightning bug and getting hit by lightning.
Latch and Saney are part of a national research effort to capture images of the sun's corona across the path of totality. They are training citizen scientists in Maine to use telescopes to take photos of the eclipse. They will be stationed in Jackman, Millinocket, and Houlton. The images captured will provide rare scientific data.
We are trying to learn about the corona of the sun. Because we're not seeing it that often, we don't know too much about it.
The corona is the atmosphere around the sun, and it's only visible during a total solar eclipse. The corona influences space weather, and scientists are still learning about how that impacts Earth. Major scientific discoveries have happened during total solar eclipses.
We first discovered in the 1860s, discovered the element helium, from the Greek word helios, meaning sun. And in 1919, it was used, a total solar eclipse was used to prove Einstein's theory of relativity.
The only thing that might obstruct viewing the corona on April 8th? The weather. But even if it's not a clear day, Latch says you'll still notice environmental changes like darkness and the temperature dropping. And PSA, protect your eyes and wear solar eclipse glasses. But don't forget to take them off during totality. That's the only time you can safely look directly at the sun and view the corona, as the sun is completely covered by the moon. So there's a lot of hype around the total solar eclipse. People say they're changed after viewing one. They scream, they cry, some chase them around the world. Ancient people even feared them. It makes me wonder, what does it mean to witness this cosmic event?
People have been observing total solar eclipses for thousands of years, and they've been wowed by them for thousands of years. And so there is this sense when you watch one that you're participating in this kind of grand sweep of history, right? There's something very primal and eternal about a total solar eclipse.
This is something on its own cycle and rhythms that is so much bigger and larger than any of us. I think that's one of the draws of it.
Bausma will see her first total solar eclipse on April 8th. Like many artists, she plans to write about it.
I like things that make me feel small, right? You know, that smallness, I think, is sometimes really helpful. We get too large in our own heads sometimes, and to feel smaller is both to feel somewhat alone, but also to feel very connected.
And for that brief moment in the shadow of the moon, you're going to realize you're on a planet, and space is a mighty big place. It's unique. Philosophers have been juggling in this for many centuries, but it's only during a total solar eclipse that you will have that encounter.
I know I'm exhilarated by the prospect. And after April 8th, the next total solar eclipse passing through Maine won't be until 2079. For now, that's the total solar eclipse explained. As Maine's official public media organization, we're proud to bring free radio, television, and digital news and entertainment to Mainers every day. Support our work at mainepublic.org/donate.